Hey folks, Chuck Holton here. I just wanted to give you a personal message this morning and let you know that my mom, Kathy Holton, went home to be with Jesus at about 2:30 this morning. She's not in any more pain. She's not suffering anymore. I think about Romans 8:21, where it talks about that we have that hope that we will be set free from our bondage to decay and obtain the freedom of the glory of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation has been groaning together like pains of childbirth. Not the creation only, but we ourselves who have the first fruits of the Holy Spirit, we also groan, waiting for our adoption as sons and the redemption of our bodies. In that hope, we are saved. And that's exactly what our hope is today. My hope is that right now, even right now, my mother's more alive than she's ever been. And she's reunited with my dad, who she's been missing terribly for more than 7 years. And she's gotten to finally hear those words that she's longed to hear her entire life from Jesus himself. Well done, good and faithful servant. I'm so grateful to have had a mom that showed me what it meant to be faithful in life and in death. She suffered greatly over the last several months, and many of you helped out a lot in making her more comfortable, making this process smoother for her. And I just want you to know how grateful we are to you, to Linda and Lynette and Pastor Mark and Pastor Jared, and so many of you who came and visited her in her last days. That meant so much to her. I'm thankful to my Aunt Ginger for helping take care of so many details, and to Grandma for putting up with all of us being in her house for the last several months. But now we're really celebrating. We're celebrating that finally, my mother has been released from the bondage to decay and has obtained the freedom of the glory of the children of God. So thank you for all your prayers. We really covet them going forward. I think the thing that makes me saddest is that we can't have a funeral right away, but we'll have a memorial service sometime as soon as this virus thing is over. And I hope to see many of you there and hug your neck, forget about social distancing for a while, and just say thank you to you personally for what you meant in my mom's life. And I know you still mean a lot to her. And she prayed for you. I've been going through her journals and looking over just her notes. She kept a lot of notes that she's taken over the last few years. And I want you to know that she was very intentional about praying for all of you. And I just can't imagine that now that she's face to face with Jesus, that she'll stop talking to him about you. So she is free, and praise God for that. Thanks for being a part of her life and of ours.